Good Thursday evening, everybody. Come on in. It's time to cook a little quick meal. I'm going to do a very quick shrimp fried rice dish. I've already got my rice cooked. I cooked some jasmine rice early in the day. Got it all cooled down and ready to go. I got about 2 pounds of shrimp clean, ready to go. And I got some peppers and onion. I like to put peppers and onions in my fried rice. So I'm going to go ahead and put the peppers and onions, medium onion, medium green pepper. I'm going to be throwing my shrimp in here, sure. I'm going to let these peppers and onions saute a little bit before I throw the shrimp in with it. And everything but the kitchen sink seasoning, you know you got to put that in there. Okay. About a teaspoon of that. Get it going. Get it going on, y'all. And of course, you know I'm sauteing these peppers and onions and my favorite thing, olive oil. So we're going to put a little bit of that. More of that in there. Excuse me. And of course, I've got my already chopped. See how handy these are? When you got them already chopped, all you got to do is just get them out and use them, y'all. I didn't have to worry with chopping them. I'm going to put a couple of tablespoons of my already chopped garlic. God, I almost forgot what it was. And look, I have probably eaten as much as I've cooked with, because I love, because it tastes so good chopped over some rice. So I did come on some rice. So we got the peppers and onions going. Get them. Whew, that smells so good, so good, so good. Okay, now I'm gonna put, got some extra garlic powder. Just gonna give this a stir. I'm gonna saute this for about 5 or 6 minutes and let it get a little softened up. And then when it gets softened up enough, I'm going to go ahead and put in my shrimp and let them do their thing. Throw that rice in. We're going to have us some shrimp fried rice. It doesn't take a lot. It does not take a lot. And we'll put it in, I got some fajita seasoning I've been had over here. I'm just chomping at the bit. I only used it one time, and I can't remember really if it was good, bad, or indifferent, y'all. So I'm going to put in some, I call this right here, this is a mixture of turmeric, coriander, cumin, and curry powder. So I'm going to put a little bit of that in my mixture. You know how I like to mix everything unto itself. Okay. Got all of that going. All of that going on in there. Make sure these veggies are real nice and seasoned. Before I can put in my other ingredients, because you know I'm gonna sprinkle my not a lot, but just a little. I'm gonna have my shrimp, gonna be shrimp sprinkled in some of my everything but the kitchen sink seasoning, so I make sure that it has its own flavor going on. And then when we mix them all up together, everything will be everything. Y'all remember that song, Everything Be Everything? I'm going to put me a little bit of onion and garlic powder on my shrimp. Okay. We're just about ready to get those shrimp in here. So before I do though, I'm going to get my onion powder going. About a teaspoon. About a good teaspoon of onion powder on those shrimp. And another teaspoon. Keep that heat up high. If you know when these shrimp go in, shrimp will make a little water in it, but I'm going to reduce all that water down, and I'll just be seasoning it with some, I'm going to put me some, put some, oh, that's my garlic. I'm going to have my garlic powder out, didn't even see it. Get those shrimp seasoned real good. I'll put just a little of my chicken bouillon. That chicken bouillon seasoning, it seasons up so well. I'm just putting not a lot now because you know shrimp absorbs. So I'm going to put about a half a teaspoon just for flavoring, y'all. Okay, then I'm going to start putting my shrimp in. Just like so. And you know, you can put this as a wok. It was actually the top out of the way. So I get those shrimp all around the sides of this thing. And I'm not putting them all in all at once, just shovel them in. I'm just going to put them in bit by bit, like so. Okay. We got the shrimp in. So what I'm going to do now is just incorporate everything. You know it's not going to take that long for the shrimp to go ahead and cook. And when they get nice and pinkish, that pinkish look to them, they know that they're ready. Okay? So we're just going to let them cook. Okay. Okay. So we're just going to keep them going because I don't want them to sit and start making a lot of juice. I mean, I want a little bit so it'll coat the rice. Okay. And of course, I'm going to hit them with some curry powder. Put a little bit of curry. Not a lot. Not everything, but the kitchen sink has the curry in it also. So we'll get everything going in here. And, oh, yeah, that smells very good. And then I'm going to get some of my Dr. Gundy's, a little bit of Dr. Gundy's olive oil running on the shrimp. Just a little, not a lot, because it has a very strong taste. And I don't want them to get overpowered. Mm. Okay. So we got these going pretty good, y'all. So we get all this mixed in and pretty much cooked. We'll start adding the rice in and I'll save some of the seasonings for the rice. Okay. We're almost there. Besides, I think I got a little bit of coleslaw mix that I'm going to put in with this. But for the most part, we're just going to do shrimp fried rice, y'all. Mmm. That smells so, so good, y'all. So good. And those shrimp are cooking nicely. And they did not form a lot of water, which is what I did not want them to do, because I like for the just the seasoning off of that shrimp to coat that rice without having a bunch of juice in the pan. I'll get my butter over here because I like to put a little bit of butter in. Okay, we're going to cook these about another 2 or 3 minutes to make sure they're good and done before I start putting in the rice. This is 2 cups of cooked rice, by the way, y'all. The shrimp is about 2.5 pounds of shrimp. About 2.5 pounds. Wonderful. Now I'm going to start putting my rice in. Oh wow, this is so wonderful. A little bit more olive oil, y'all. This is going to be so good. Might add just a little bit more turmeric. I'm sorry, not turmeric, some curry. Forgetting my seasoning's name. A little bit of curry powder. A And this is the last of the rice, y'all. Last of the rice. All the rice is in. And now it's just a matter of getting it all mixed in. You can sort of lower the heat on now because everything is cooked. Just mixing and blending. I'm going to put in about a fourth of a cup of butter. I like to add butter. Sorry about that. I like to add butter to this mixture. And once you start, once you got your rice cooked and all your prep work done, really not a lot of time. So I think, you know, it takes 20 minutes to cook this rice, prep and saute these shrimp, and maybe another 20 minutes. So you probably got about 45 minutes to cook this entire dish, y'all. You have to keep stirring. Just keep stirring it until you get all the rice in and mixed. And of course, I said, like this dish, I will put a little bit of more soy sauce in it. Well, if I can get it open. A little bit of soy sauce. Just a little bit. I thought I had some sesame oil. I like to put sesame oil seasoning in my stir fry, but I don't have any. I guess I used it all and forgot about it. But you, as you can see, this shrimp fried rice is a very simple, simple dish. We'll be right back. I need me a bottle. These little handles look pretty hot, y'all. But as you can see, everything is pretty getting mixed up pretty good. So I'll be stirring and mixing in this for the next 5 or 6 minutes. But the heat is pretty much all the way down. So now what is happening, we're getting it mixed and we're letting that rice heat right on through and get all that good seasoning on there. So we're ready to sit down and relax and eat us a big old hot plate full of shrimp fried rice. And I've got some fish that I did last night. I'm gonna get that fish out. We're gonna crumble it, heat it and crumble it right on top of there for extra fish. Oh yes, I do. You know, last night I cooked the swipe fish. And I still have some swipe fish left over, so I'm just gonna reheat that swipe fish and lay it right on top. See, that's the beauty of leftovers. But we're just going to keep stirring this rice. And I believe maybe I might have to add a little more season, but I don't think so, because I think the shrimp was seasoned up pretty good. And I did the soy sauce in there. And I may need to put just a little bit more of whatever. We'll see though here in short. Because you know, we got to remember I told y'all, when you're cooking like this, as far as salt is concerned, please taste your food and make sure it has enough salt in it before you put it on the table, so nobody will be asking for the salt box. That's also perfect, y'all. So, that's yummy. Yummy, yummy, yummy. So we'll be right back. I'm going to get my fish ready. Okay, y'all, there it is. All in its glory, that beautiful shrimp fried rice, y'all. There it is. And I'm going to go ahead and chop some tomatoes and cucumbers since I'm not cooking a whole lot. I'm not cooking really any sides with this. So I'm just going to go right ahead. Slice a tomato and a cucumber, and that's what we're going to have as a side, tomatoes and cucumbers. I think that'll work. If I got an avocado that's ripe, I think I might even chop an avocado to go with that as well, but we don't know yet.
So let's see. Yeah, this is another one of those quick meals. You know, I'm still cooking those quick meals in this kitchen. Oh, wow, look at that tomato. We can use that around. It has a little deep recess. Listen, y'all, I'm looking at the, as I slice it, I'm going to go ahead and put it right here on my little serving plate. Nothing fancy. I'm going to slice some ringlets like so. Tomato. Let me turn that music off that I do not claim, y'all. Hold on 1 second. I'm looking all different track and field for the world championship. You know, this is leading up to the Olympics in 2024, y'all. I think it's Paris, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. Correct me if I'm wrong, y'all, but I love track and field. Anything to do with track, I love it. So what I'm going to do is I am going to just sprinkle these tomatoes with a little of my cilantro lime seasoning. Just a little bit. Then I'm going to hit it with a little bit of salt. A little of my Himalayan pink. Okay, that should do it. And then what I'm going to do with them, I'm just going to cut them in half. And then I'll cut them in four, since this is a pretty good sized tomato. And we're just going to lay them right there on the plate. So all we're doing, nothing out of the ordinary. Just something to cool. Go in your mouth cool along with that, this good old, it's going to be a pretty looking, kind of pretty. I'm not going to completely peel this cucumber. I'm just going to skim it a little bit. And then I'll just cut it up and leave some green just for color, y'all. Just for a little bit of color. I should have my peel. It's somewhere around here. Okay, just for effect. I'm gonna slice them as thin as I can. I don't like them too thick when I'm doing this. Well, am I going to need two cucumbers? Or just one gonna be enough, y'all think? We shall see. Okay, so I will be done with this in a minute and I'll be right back, y'all. Okay, everything's ready. I'm gonna go ahead and drizzle these veggies with a little bit of my balsamic vinaigrette. This tastes good over tomatoes and cucumbers. We're just having a light dinner tonight. This is very light, y'all. Okay. Just a little drizzle is all I'm trying to put on here, y'all. Okay, there we go. So everything's ready. We got the shrimp fried rice, and like I said, we got these nice cucumbers and tomatoes. And that's our dinner for tonight, y'all. So, thank y'all for stopping by. Thank y'all for your prayers, your well wishes, your comments, your compliments, questions, encouragement, everything. Just thank you, thank you, thank you, you all. Always glad to have y'all stop by. Thank you for continuing to pray without ceasing, most of all. So, you know, you can add some extra soy sauce to this shrimp fried rice if you'd like, or just leave it like it is. And of course, to complement that shrimp fried rice, I've got that cucumber and tomato salad, we'll call it. So we get ready to sit back, relax, and just enjoy a good, quiet, simple, just easy, breezy meal. Because trust me, this was easy to make. It's Thursday, almost the end of the week. And I tell you what, y'all, I am just about ready to call it weekend. Thank God it's Friday tomorrow, y'all. Thank you, thank you, thank you one more time for stopping by. Thank you for your prayers. Please continue to pray without ceasing, no matter what. Pray especially for our children, our school children. You know, even though they're just going back, I talked to Noreek last night. Pray for their health as well, because these little viruses and things are going around. We ain't claiming nothing, but we sure can get together and chase one can chase 1,000, but two can chase 10,000. So we're going to chase away these little old viruses that's trying to claim our children. And we're just going to usher in good health, good spirit, lots of learning. Tania, I don't know if I told y'all, 92 on her first grading cycle. So she's doing really well. She's been in school, 2 months right now. That little baby boy just growing. I have to get pictures of him. That little great grand, I mean to tell you, he just as cute as a button, along with my little P. Haven't seen her in about a week. But anyway, y'all, stay cool, be kind, cook yourself some good food, pray without ceasing, do something kind for somebody. You can find somebody to do something kind for. So until I decide to cook again, sorry about that, y'all. I could hear Tanya's voice behind me saying, Mom, wipe that lens off. So I had to stop and wipe my lens off. My lens was kind of cloudy on me there a little bit. So anyway, until I decide to cook again, y'all, thank you for stopping by. Love you guys. Pray without ceasing. We're praying for the world, of course, like we've been doing all year long, and we're going to continue to do. Do y'all realize it's September is moving like it's on a jet plane, and pretty soon Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year, it will be the end of the year before we can blink real hard. So we got to start thinking about holiday stuff, shopping. Come on now. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to bring it up, y'all, but I just felt like I needed to a little bit. So anywho, y'all, love you guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you for your prayers and in your comments. I always feel your prayers. So thanks again for always thinking about me and for always praying without ceasing. So until I decide to cook again, guys, love you. Toodles.